Hi guys, it's MJ, and if you can't tell from the swatches on my face, we're reviewing some shit today. I have had to redo this intro 5 times because I can't say the word reviewing right now. But we're going to be doing some super cool things. We're going to be going over a bunch of new hard candy products, and we're going to be trying out a bunch of lip products, including Blooming Lip Oil. They came out with another color. They heard me. The heavens smiled and they heard me. Stop, stop, stop. No 3-minute intro today, guys. Just stay tuned. We're reviewing some stuff and thank you for coming back to see me. The first thing I want to review, I am so excited. I have been hunting this product down. I've spent probably the last month and a half trying to get a hold of it. It's from Hard Candy, and several of these products are. It is the Sheer Envy Coconut Water Cooling Primer Stick. So I have the cooling chill spray from Urban Decay and I freaking love it. But this is a primer stick and I'm getting really into stick foundations. The Maybelline Fit Me is probably my favorite for a stick foundation. I'm very happy with it. But let's take a look at this guy. So this guy was $8 and you get 0.42 ounces. Little bit light, but nothing crazy. Most of the time with a decent foundation, you're looking at 1 full fluid ounce. And the same with primers. It is this water-based primer stick instantly cools your skin as it preps your face for flawless makeup application. This cool primer is packed with ingredients that leave your skin looking silky, even-toned, and pore-perfected while hydrating and soothing the skin. To apply, glide primer stick directly onto face and blend before makeup application. I've not touched any of this stuff, by the way. Like, it's been killing me. It's been, like, in a bucket next to my desk. And I'm like, it's right there. I just want to play with it. But I haven't because I wanted you guys to see live reactions. So let's open this up. And it's got, like, a little cappy thing. And it's slightly like a sky blue in color. I don't know if you guys know this, but the way that Hard Candy got super famous was, oh my God, topaz. Stop. The way that Hard Candy got super famous was a sky blue nail polish that some celebrity spoke about on a talk show, and they just blew up, and they still make it, and it's called Sky, and it comes like a little ring, and this isn't sponsored. I just really like their products. It's very fresh smelling. It doesn't smell like coconut. I kind of wish it did. I love that smell. Ooh. Oh, that's weird. It's got like a glue stick feeling on your face. I don't know if that's weird or not. But so I'm just sliding this all over the place. It's totally clear. Oh, there's a little coconut. Like, I think if you break through that top layer, you get a little more coconutty. And it has that really nice tacky feeling that like a good primer has. It does smell more coconutty as you start to work with it. I don't mind it. It's very light, but if you hate that smell, this is not going to be for you. It does seem to have a slightly pore defense look to it. Topaz and Accent have been having a discussion for the past like hour. I don't know what he said, but she's not happy with him. So I like that. That feels really good on my face. I'm going to throw a little bit of foundation on and see what this looks like with foundation on top of it. So I'm going to be honest and say that I don't know if I'm having a bad blending day or if it's the primer, but my foundation is not acting correctly. It's kind of, it's not sticking to my skin. It's coming right back up. It's not soaking into my skin. I don't know. I'm going to have to wear test this to tell you a little bit more about it. But, like, I even switched to a different foundation thinking something was wrong with my Ulta one. And I used my Fit Me stick, which always works. And it's just not. Like, it looks shitty. I'm probably going to just throw, like, a heavier powder foundation over all of this. So I went ahead and threw on just a powder foundation over everything and touched up my eyebrows. You are going to notice glitter frickin' everywhere because I just filmed for my St. Patrick's look, and the glitter is a real issue. It's everywhere. That Too Faced glitter is the shit, but once it's on you, you better like it because you're gonna be finding it in your nose crevices and in your eyebrows for the next like 3 weeks. So I have made a commitment to this glitter. Let's move on to our next product. I have three lip products to show you guys today. So I don't know if Hard Candy was reading my mind, if they were out there and they're like, Broomstck88, do you hear that? She says she loves the blooming lip oils. She says she needs more colors. Let's get on this. Oh my God. Because they came out with, I shit you not, a color that speaks to my soul. This is the Blooming Lip Oil in Black Rose. And I saw this when I was in the grocery store and I looked like shit buckets. Like normally, if I'm gonna makeup brows, I wear makeup because then if someone's like, oh, what do you recommend? I can be like, oh, here's one of my business cards. I recommend this and this is why, and I have a YouTube channel. And this time I was like half ponytail up, like glasses on, no makeup, sweatpants. I don't wear sweatpants in public. I have a problem with sweatpants in public. And I saw it and I turned around and went, oh shit! And I was screaming it in the aisle of Walmart, and people were like, and I was like, don't judge this. I just asked for this on Instagram like an hour ago. And it's so pretty, and the container is a little bit darker than like the original blooming oils. The original ones were like a sleek like pearlescent and they just said the name on it. And this one is dark and mysterious and I need to put this on my face. I'm not gonna lie, YouTube, I got a little bit of lady boner right now. Oh, this is the color. The formula is just as amazing as the original formulas. It feels so good. What is it? Does it smell like anything? Because the other ones smell kind of like florally. Hold on. Nope, doesn't really smell like anything. It is, I don't even want to try the other two now. I just love this. So this is the Blooming Lip Oil. It's Hard Candy, only at Walmart, $5. And I just love this. I don't want to take it off. Oh, and it stains just like the other ones do. These blooming lip oils are all day wear. Like once it's on, that's a commitment. It's gonna stay on. You just reapply for moisture a little bit, but that's it. Like that's all you need to do. The second thing is also Hard Candy. I swear this isn't sponsored. I just really like their shit. This is Bloodline. It is another one of their Fierce Effects cream lipsticks. It is a beautiful dark, dark, dark brown with red undertones. There we go. It definitely needs a lip liner. It needs some help underneath. However, the color touches my little Rachel from Friends heart. It is so pretty. It is so, it's soft. It tastes good. Like all their lips, the Fierce Effects lipsticks kind of taste good. I don't know if that's weird or if it's supposed to or not, but I really like it. Like I'm looking at my little mirror down here. And I am a fan. Feels good on the lips. It really does need a liner. And it comes off on your teeth really easily. Ooh. I like it. I like this. The final lip product that we're gonna be trying out is from Wet n Wild. It is a Pout and Love Gel Lip Balm. Let's see if they have anything special on here. It's brand new. I got the color Love, which looks like it was like a mauvey pink. It is their first gel lip balm. Smooth application, lasting moisture, sheer and glossy. They are a cruelty-free brand, which is really cool. I have no idea if they're vegan or not, and it's not something that affects my buying decision, so I don't know. That's up to you guys to look up. Oh, winners today. No, legit. Super, super sheer. Like, barely any color. But the color you do get is very true. It's not patchy. It's exactly the color that's on here. Feels like silk, too. Like, it feels better than any gel lip product or butter lipstick I've ever tried. That's really pretty. I'm glad I actually tried this one on last because I'm going to leave it on while I do my eyes. For our eyes today, it is another hard candy product. If you guys just want to get on this and sponsor me, I mean, I'm already making half my videos about your stuff because you're just so amazing. I mean, just hint, hint, nudge, nudge. But moving on. This dude. This is the Look Pro Matte Eyeshadow Pro Palette. It was $10, which is a total steal for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15 colors. Which is, they're big too. Like, what are we looking at in size here? Net was 0.69 of an ounce. That's a big palette. And it shows like on the back, it's got like little ideas of things that you can do. Simple to dramatic, neutral to bold. It comes with, the packaging's heavy duty too. Like, I like this packaging. I'm a fan of that. It comes with two little brushes. Let's play with it. I'll swatch on the face in a moment, but I have a new chair, sorry, and like I can't find a comfortable position. I wanted something with no back on it because that way you can see my pretty backdrop that my grandma bought me. But at the same time, I keep like slowly like, I'm spinning away. I'm getting away from you. Oh no. So I keep like shifting to find the spot that's not going to shifty me away from you guys. If you guys hear all kinds of like weird like whistling noises behind me, we are having a nor'easter in New England right now, which is basically a big storm that ruins your weekend. Let's try these little brushes. Ooh, they're double-ended. Look at these. So we have a little heavy blendy brush, which is very soft. And then a flat packing brush, a rounded top blending brush, also very soft, and a itty bitty little pencil brush. Okay, let's play with it. Let's do some stuff. We talked about their signature nail polish was blue. We're gonna try out this baby blue color right here. Hold on. We're gonna try two things. We're gonna be on top of this. We are gonna throw a primer on one eye. So one eye primer, one eye no primer. Oh, fucking glitter. Oh, so much glitter. Okay. Let's go back in. We're gonna do the baby blue color. And I'm gonna put this all over my mobile lid. The little brush seems to pick up a lot of fabric, tends to pick up a lot of pigment. There is not a lot of kickback on this palette. This blue is very pastel, but it's got like a little bit of like a gray periwinkle undertone. I'm kind of really enjoying it. Actually, over the top of the white primer, I'm really, really enjoying it. Enough that I'm going to throw some white primer on my other lid because I want this whole look to look phenomenal. And it is just, it needs a primer. I prefer a white primer. You can use whatever the hell you want to use. These little brushes are killing it. Good for you, Hard Candy. Well done. Okay, so I have that baby periwinkle blue all over my lids. And now I'm going to pick up this buttercream yellow shade right here. And I'm going to work in from the inner corner. I am already going to say that for $10... if you can go to Walmart and buy this palette or hop on their website and buy this palette, this is worth your money. This is a cute, adorable little palette The color payoff on a white primer is phenomenal. Without the white primer, the pastels were light, but I mean, we'll see in a couple of minutes what the darks do without a primer on them, because I'm going to face swatch. Now that I have the yellow going from my inner corner and then up across my crease, I'm going to darken up the outer corner just a little bit. I don't want to go super dark, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with this medium smoky gray color. I'm going to go a little darker than that. Okay, we're going to work our way in and go to this plummy brown. Oh, there we go. That's kind of more what I was looking for. This would be a great travel kit. Like, I'm going on vacation in a few weeks. I might bring this. I am going to pop out and grab one of my regular blending brushes, because they're not blending very well on the outsides here. So I'm just going to grab a normal blending brush for me. Oh, that's better. Yeah. Something I am not as crazy about is I don't prefer palettes that are all mattes, because I like a shimmery brow highlight and a shimmery inner highlight. I like glitter, and I'm not getting glitter out of this. That's fine. Like, a lot of people don't like glitter. I just wish they had like maybe two highlight shades in here that were glittery, because they do make nice highlighters. It's just there's not one in here for me. I'm gonna pick up this super pastel pink and just like what we were talking about, I'm gonna highlight my brow. That is really like soft and light and pastel-y, but gorgeous, and I love it. So this so far for what I have on my face, I really like. Let's swatch on my cheek and 15 colors. We've got a lot of spots here. So we will swatch with and without primer. The first swatching that we're gonna do is I'm gonna go across this top line right here. That's pigmented. Okay. Play with that later. You all know how much I love a red eyeshadow. So, swatching thoughts here. The pastels are pastel. That's what it is. They're pastel. They are their name. The pastels are very pretty, but you'll definitely need to layer them up, and you definitely need to have a base underneath them. The middle row is kind of 50-50. Some of them are really vibrant on their own, like these two right here in that taupey shade. Some of them look better on a base, but it's a hit or miss. And the bottom row, same thing. So like, this is beautiful. These are very vibrant. I love that red. Ooh. But then over here, it just adds a little extra kick to them. Like this purple, these two purples showed up a little bit nicer. That gray showed up a little bit nicer. And that red is still just, I like that red. That red and I are gonna have some discussions. Cool. Cool frijoles. I'm not even gonna put on eyeliner. No, I'm not feeling any eyeliner right now. No eyeliner for me. I am gonna put that blooming lip oil back on though, because it's so pretty. Okay, hard candy. I'm gonna make some suggestions. You ready? Are you ready? I'm in my suggestion pose. Blooming lip oils. I want one that's got a little bit of a blue tint, so it makes my teeth look all white and pretty. I would love one that has a mint flavor to it, because if it was minty fresh, I think with the oil and the mint would be amazing. And I'd like one that's really, really dark, and then one that's really, really red. Neither the Zen Strawberry or the Calming Peach or this guy are really red. I want a red one. Right here. Can you hear me? Pay attention. Red. We need red. Because, I like this. This is good stuff. Okay, final thoughts, friends. All the lip products I tried, I love them. We had the Hard Candy Blooming Lip Oil. We had the Pout and Love Gel Balm from Wet n Wild. And we had the Bloodline Fierce Effects, the brown lipstick from Hard Candy. All of them I loved. Blooming Lip Oil, whoa, so pretty. Amazing texture on this little Wet n Wild guy. I'm probably gonna end up going back and purchasing a few more of them. I wanted to try it out first because I've kind of been spending a little bit more money than I would normally spend on makeup, but whatever. There's no makeup anonymous. The Fierce Effects is beautiful, but needs a base. If you don't have a base on it, it just kind of smears around a little bit and it's slightly patchy. So, phenomenal. No extra nom on this guy. It's like my grading scale is the nom levels. The primer stick, I'm gonna need to do a little bit more research on this guy. I don't know if my foundation just went on shitty today or if this caused my foundation to not go on nicely, but I don't like how my skin looks like right now. Even like after a few minutes of wearing it, I have all these like creasy spots and my skin's not looking very flattering, and I'm not sure if it's this or if it's my foundation. So I will probably try this with a few different types of foundation to see what's going on. And last but very much not least, this is a steal. This little guy right here was like 10 bucks. And other than the fact that I wish it had like one or two highlighty shimmery shades in it, the palette itself is very user-friendly, very beginner-friendly. The little brushes that came with, I used them and I liked them. I will be wearing more of this. I'll probably be wearing this to work tomorrow. If you like matte eyeshadow and you want to try something out, except for don't forget to blend like I did. Pause. By the way, I have like a little pimple right here that I can't get rid of, and that's causing some blending issues of its own. I know, sexy, right? This guy is worth the $10, definitely. It's not a, oh my God, have to have it, like the Blooming Lip Oil is, but it's one of those, I'm like, yeah, I do not regret spending the money on this, and I would definitely recommend other people to purchase it. So thank you for stopping by, and thanks for hanging out with me.